I learned recently that many of the old black spiritual songs, songs like Every Time I Feel the Spirit, Swing Low, Sweet Chariot, songs that we used to love to hear Brother Darcel McCoy sing at preaching conference and other places, that those songs are played on the five black notes of the piano, and that those five notes make up the pentatonic scale. And the melody of our offertory song tonight follows that exact same scale of keys and is possibly the most well-beloved song of all time. This song is Amazing Grace, and of course we just sang about the amazing love, and right up there with that is the amazing grace of God. Of course, this song was written by John Newton, who in his younger years was captain of a slave ship and then saved by God's amazing grace. It's entirely possible that John heard this melody coming up from the poor slaves on his ship, then later put these famous words to the song. In fact, if you look at page 236 of your song book, and you'll see the song Amazing Grace, it says there that the author is John Newton, but the melody, it says there, is American. It doesn't have a name for that. If you go to the Library of Congress and places where it's authentically written, it says that the melody is unknown. And John Newton wrote the words and the music. We don't know for sure, of course, where it came from, but it's very possible it came out of the bottom of that ship that he rode on. John would later write a pamphlet, of course, expressing the great regret that he had in the wretched practice of the slave trade. And so he even says in the song, of course, that God saved a wretch like me, and he truly felt that way. This pamphlet was reprinted many times and used by William Wilberforce in England, and later was very instrumental in England outlawing slavery. So the song, the words, some of the words, Amazing Grace, it's a song of jubilation. It's not a song of sadness or regret, certainly, but it's a song of excitement. John Newton just standing there in awe and disbelief that God would reveal to him, a wretched sinner that he was, amazing grace. How sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. He says, I once was lost, but now I'm found, was blind, but now I see. In the last verse, when we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, we've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun. What a glorious day that will be. When John, in his book John the Beloved, he described the word that was made flesh and dwelt among us. He said that Christ, one of the first descriptions of him, he's full of grace and truth. Christ is the epitome of grace. One of the 12 times in the book of Ephesians where Paul mentions the word grace, he says in chapter 2, verse 7, that in the ages to come, he might show or reveal the exceeding riches of his grace in his kindness toward us through Christ Jesus. Something for us to purely stand in amazement and awe is the grace of God along with the love of God. Let's pray for the offering. Thank you, Lord, for your grace. Thank you for your love for us. Thank you, God, for this great week that we've had and how challenging the messages have been to us. I pray, God, that you bless this offering. May we see your hand upon this service tonight. May we know your presence tonight, and we thank you for meeting with us already this week. We ask that you bless this service tonight. In Jesus' name, amen.